You'd better be ready to show your moves, because he is here! What is up, YouTube? I am NintendoMan64, bringing you the next episode of Super Smash Bros. Brawl. As we progress through the subspace story mode, we are now outside the ancient ruins. And the Pikmin are attacking the Rob. Either these Robs are really, really huge, or Olimar is really, really small. But there is only one man who can save the day. The greatest man in the history of man! Captain Falcon! Who commits genocide of Pikmin because he can do that. And Olimar just really doesn't care. Like, look at him. He just does not give the slightest amount of a shit that Captain Falcon just killed all those Pikmin. He just does not care. Oh, Captain Falcon. Oh, the good old days. When I first started playing Melee, after a few weeks of ironing out how good I was with certain characters, Captain Falcon became my best. And he is still one of my best characters in all of Smashdom. The speed and power combination he possesses is nothing short of awesome. And I fully intend to take advantage of his speed and power potential. Olimar, on the other hand, is one of my least favorites. And I... Oh, missed the trophy. God damn it. Okay, let's try this again. Alright, and let's go... Oh, son of a bitch! Okay, trophies. Trophy! You will be mine! No! Oh my god! Why can you not grab a simple trophy? Falcon Man! What the hell? You need to show this trophy your moves! Oh no! All those trophies fall into their deaths. It's so sad. No! Oh my god, is this happening right now? I can't even pick up one goddamn trophy! Oh, thank god! Oh. You have no moves, Captain Falcon. I'm sorry, you don't. Booyakasha! He didn't even break his shell! Fan four stick! Friggin' Robs everywhere. You are right that we are close to the research facility and wherever the hell that Samus and Pikachu were going. Ow! That was rude. Oh, I missed. Come on, we gotta hit the head. Hit the head. Head! And stop shooting at me! I will Falcon Punch you, and I will not hesitate to do it! No hesitation whatsoever. Ow, ow, impalement. It's not fun. Impalement is definitely not fun. Impalement is most definitely not fun. Oh my god, I blew myself up! Not even the effort, he just moves it, lobs his foot at the thing and he kills him. Good old Captain Falcon. Ow. That was rude. all Raptor Drive. You are also a good friend of mine. Not as much as the Falcon Punch, but you are still a good friend of mine. Oh, well, goodbye then. I don't know how the hell that happened, but okay. Alright, Olimar. You're up. Not for nothing, I suck with Olimar. Another character that people say is pretty decent, but I suck with. Ooh, CD! Must get the CD! Suicide be damned! Oh, what happened to all my Pikmin? What the hell is this crap? I had like 6! Where'd they all go? Game, you stole my Pikmin! What is this? What is this? Ow, right in the face. Fly, my pretties! Fly! Fly! We're all present and accounted for? Good. Alright, let's keep going. How did Diddy Kong even fit in there? Oh my god, him and his freaking jetpacks. Captain Falcon likes the monkey! Captain Falcon will jump now! And there's the gorilla! Or the ape. Captain Falcon likes you, monkey! Captain Falcon would like to make you his sidekick in his anime he is writing! My god. Captain Falcon is ready to fight with the monkey and the ape and the big-nosed alien thing. He is unafraid of battling these primids. Sorry, not he. Captain Falcon is unafraid of battling these primids. For Captain Falcon is the savior of mankind. That did not hurt Captain Falcon. Though good try anyway. It did not hurt Captain Falcon because I am Captain Falcon. Ow, this is gonna hurt. Ha ha! Captain Falcon succeeds in turning you into a trophy. Captain Falcon wishes you would stop blowing him up. Captain Falcon wishes you would stop slapping him with your swords. Captain Falcon is unhappy that you blew him up. Thank God he died, actually. I didn't know how much longer I'd have to put up with that. Oh, way to kill yourself. No, 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 no! God! Damn it all! Donkey Kong was around for like 3 seconds! Oh, well. No, that's a mini mushroom. I'm not that stupid. Blow you up! Why don't you blow me up, buttercup baby! Goddamn metal primates! Why does everything fall to fucking Olimar? Every goddamn time! Hey, rude. Rude. Wait, did you just deflect that bomb? How dare you? Oh no, you didn't. Okay, we're good. Oh, good riddance. And Captain Falcon appreciates the monkey saying goodbye to his friend. And Falco goes off to go do something. No one knows what. He's Falco, he can go do whatever he wants. Hey, Hawk! The single worst joke in the history of history. I remember that joke that Chugga made in their Smash Let's Play. Was his first name Mike? My god. Alright, where are we now? Ooh, the Glacial Peak, another good level. Let's save here first. Shut up, cat! No one cares! Don't start with me! Don't start with me! Well, the Arwing is battling Meta Knight's ship. Why is Meta Knight's ship so huge? And Meta Knight's like, I'm gonna go get my ship back. Yes, you heard that. I'm getting my shit and my ship back. And then the Ice Climbers just showed up. You can't have anything that involves ice without them. Not at all. The question is, are they trying to battle him on his way to the top? Or they realize, oh shit, is he a good guy or what? No one knows. But the Ice Climbers are sort of like Olimar. If you take out Olimar's Pikmin, he is effectively the most useless character in the game. If you take out Nana of the Ice Climbers, the pink one who you don't control, as you control Popo, then Popo is the most useless character in the game. But together, the two are, without a doubt, the best one, arguably the best combo hitters in the game. And it's very, I was very upset when I found out that they were written out of Wii U. Poor Ice Climbers. They wrote them out in style. Like, it was rude to write them out. I was sad. Ow! Stupid boomerang! More trophy. Oh god, spikes! Ha ha! Ow! I'm so fucking done with these boomerang guys! I'm so done with them! Like, seriously! You know what? Screw this! I'm gonna kill you the old-fashioned way. With my hammer! I smash them with the hammer! Oh my god. Why do all of these annoying enemies exist? Nintendo, what the hell? Fly up. Wait. Nana died? Oh, well, that's sad. Cat, don't start with me! Stupid animal. And there goes Popo. Oh, well. Alright, Meta Knight, let's go. Carve up them chickens! Like they're the Dickens! Look at that pose, man. So majestic. So majestic. And this friggin' mock tornado.
Fight me! I am Meta Knight!
Captain Falcon appreciates you, Meta Knight! Captain Falcon, what am I gonna do with him? All I need to say is thank God he's not in the next episode. At least I hope he's not. I don't know how much longer I'll be able to do that whole Captain Falcon thing. Captain Falcon appreciates that. Captain Falcon does not approve of you not approving of him. Oh wow, my score doesn't go up when I knock them into the crystals. That's stupid. Eh, oh well. Go away! You floos! Were you fluos, or you fluows, or... what? Beings of darkness? This isn't Kingdom Hearts! We're not playing that until at least the end of the year! And it's its sequel, because we've already played the first one. We've also played Coded Days and Chain of Memories. But 2 is a special case. I like that game. But I cannot tell you guys when it is coming, though. Like, the exact date. All I could tell you is that this is starting on the Monday after St. Paddy's Day. The first episode of this is going up. And... let's see. Depends really on how many Emerald episodes there are. Even if I don't get to the after-game stuff, which is technically half the reason I am doing the whole Emerald action replay thing, but also to build a better team than the one I built, because, let's face it, as much as I love the Pokemon that I used in the action replay, the team was very unbalanced. Oh my god, these damn freaking metal premise! Oh god, oh god! No! Oh, thank god. I was not getting squished there. Oh, hello, what have we here? Ooh, secret door. Secret door! Oh, you! Go away! You stupid boomerang bastard! Stop reminding me that Boomerang is a disgrace of a channel! That should be ashamed of itself. Because it's literally now just Cartoon Network Lite. In fact, watch. I am going to put it on my channel right now. And I am going to bet that there's either going to be something Scooby-Doo related or a crappy Cartoon Network show that's already on another channel. Booyah Kasha! Teen Titans Go! What are the friggin' odds? Seriously, what is the point of putting a show on multiple different channels that you own? It's got to be the same reason why Dan Schneider shows are so popular. They're like, hello, that got like so many views. Yeah, because, yeah, they like talk about, oh, the Kids' Choice Awards got so many good views last. Well, I don't know why it got so many good reviews the other night, or so many views and good rating. Want to know why? Because you played it on every channel you own, because, you know, everybody needs to understand what the stupid kids are picking as their winning of whatever. They give stupid shit to frickin' Demi Lovato and shit. And John Cena was hosting it. God, I'm angry. But seriously, though, unless it's a good show, what's the point of... God damn it, Nana! What the hell? Or Nana, or whatever, I don't know. Oh, thank you, Glyces, for committing your own suicide. Makes my job easier. Am I really gonna make it to the top of the mountain without Nana? Or Nana? Or Nuno? Or Nunu Numa Nima Nama Nana? Whatever. Man, I got mad there. Like, I don't think I've ever gotten that mad about anything in my life before that. Yeah, but I'm like really tired of them, like, oh, Teen Titans Go is our number one show. Wanna know why? Because you put it on 40% of your runtime. Why do you think your runtime is slowly draining each year? Like, I remember when Cartoon Network used to run to 11 o'clock. Like, it would still be running Cartoon Network themed shows until 11 o'clock when Family Guy would come on. And then it switched to 10 o'clock because he had Futurama and then Family Guy. And then it changed to American Dad and King of the Hill, and then it suddenly became 9 o'clock. And now it's 8 o'clock it's ending. Think about that. King of the Hill, a horrible show about propane, is on at an earlier time than ever before, thanks to you putting on nothing but garbage. Think about that. As Popo thinks about what to do now that his, I don't know, girlfriend or something is gone. What is their relationship? Brother and sister? I don't think it's brother and sister. Especially after watching Smash Kingdom again while I was editing last night. I think they're boyfriend and girlfriend. It doesn't really matter. Because Popo made it all the way by himself. Oh my god, I just suddenly realized. Popo became Mr. Popo. But then what does that make Lucario here? That just makes Lucario the Aura Pokemon! Oh great, cat fight. I love how they're just gonna stand there and watch these two fight. But yes, this is another branching video storyline thing. I'm gonna be Lucario here because I just was Meta Knight, and I also want to show off how to use Lucario. Lucario is a very unique fighter in this game. His damage goes up the higher his damage he receives is. So Lucario will do more damage if he's at, say, 100% than he would if he was at, say, 40%. This makes losing Lucario very difficult for newbies, so I recommend if you're Lucario, or if you're a guy that wants to use Lucario, get some experience with this game, because he can be tricky to use. Hey! That was rude. Very rude. But Lucario did end up replacing Mewtwo in Melee. Or at least that he had replaced the Mewtwo, since Mewtwo was supposed to be in this game, and they just decided, oh, let's bring Lucario in. So, are you guys done fighting? Because that was kind of a pointless fight, the more you think about it. Hey, another hawk sticker. Let's fight. Now we're friends. That's the beauty of Super Smash Bros. They fight and they kick the living crap out of each other, and then suddenly they're friends. Mario and Kirby, Meta Knight and Marth, Meta Knight and Lucario. Oh, wait, what? Who's piloting that damn thing? Oh, and there go the ice climbers. Oh, I hope they didn't want to have fun in this world. Oh, well. Alright, what's next? Oh, no, is he next? Please don't tell me he's next. Oh, no, he's not. The canyon, okay, that's fine. Alright. Oh, there come the ice climbers. At least they lived. God, look at all these primates, though. Ooh, the cavalry has arrived! Oh, no, it's these guys! Not again! I thought I was just you guys! Oh, well. Alright, let's see. Yoshi, Swagalicious, Mario, Pit, and Link. Sorry, Kirby. Sorry again, Kirby. I know you're shocked. Look at that face. I know you're shocked. But we got shit to do. And you can't absorb any of these primates. Maybe when we're fighting actual fighters again, I'll use you. But I don't know when that is. Actually, I do know when that is, but you guys aren't supposed to know when that is. Will you stop? Seriously, I should do like a top 10 list of which one of you is the more annoying of them. The boomerangs, the armites, the flues, the friggin' You guys, the fishes, those motorcycle things, the rotorants, man, they just know how to pick very obnoxious enemies. Super Giga Mecha Yoshi, Super Giga Mecha Yoshi. Yoshi's in a half shell. I know that doesn't make any sense. That wasn't singing at all remotely the same theme. But whatever. I don't care. Gliers. Actually, glices are the worst. Fire at least just launches you. Electricity is like combo damage. But the glices are the worst because they freeze you. And you can't do like anything for a few seconds. Oh, you go, Yoshi. Oh, cool, suicide. Ow, goodbye. Whee, goodbye. Oh man, look at the odds Mario has to go up against. Four giant pyramids and a roturret. It's a Super Giga Mega Mario! Woohoo! Bow chicka bow wow! Bitch! I'm Super Mario! That was a quick stage. Hajime Tanaka! Okay. Cool, I guess. But if you thought being introduced to Captain Falcon was bad, just wait who we get to see next episode. Thank you guys for joining me. I am Nintendo Man 64, and I will see you guys then. Until then, sayonara!